the craze of motorsports in India is gaining momentum. And today we have with us a world rally champion, Mr. Sanjay Takale. How are you?
I'm good and I'm fine. I'm very happy to be with you people.
We are so excited to have you here with us. And we would like to start this interview by knowing a little bit about you. So could you just introduce yourself in a few words for us?
Yes, my name is Sanjay Takale and I come from Manjri village. Taluka is Haveli and of course Pune city, my city. And about motorsports, yes, I started riding into motorsports right from a very early age. From the age of 16, I took out a license, which was of course a false license. And I started taking part into bikes. For 14 years I did bikes. Then after that I took a break and I did backpacking for 7 years. And after that, at the age of 37, I came back to rallying. And now I'm 50, so last 13 years I've been doing rallying now.
That's so exciting. So what actually made you take up rally racing? And at the age of 37, how did you take that leap of faith into it, I would say?
Actually, I never realized that I did motorsports in the early part, but I never realized that this is what I have to do in my life. After doing two-wheeler bike career and succeeding into everything what I did in my life, I couldn't sleep well. I was not able to sleep at the age of 37 also. Something just haunted me all the time. Then I just wanted to understand what's wrong. Then I realized it's sports and I have to go back to it. And that's what made me go back to motorsports.
Wow, that's really fascinating. So you followed your passion basically and age was no bar to it.
I think age is only a number. As it is said, it's all about your mentality. Yeah. If you think something you can do, you can really do. So at the age of 37, I always knew I can do this. So I started driving cars into professional competition at the age of 37. And it never occurred to me once also that I cannot do this.
Okay.
And I started with all my, and most importantly, I enjoyed doing it. So that was the most important part of it. So that kept me going for a long distance.
The 7 years that you went backpacking, would you say that helped you rediscover yourself? And how was the entire journey of traveling around the world, meeting new people?
I think, as I said, that you meet yourself, right? Yeah. When you're going and you become street smart. I used to have a $20 a day or $30 a day budget for 24 hours. So you try to be stingy, you try to be wise. And you're on the, how do I explain it? You're on a normal budget with normal people, down to earth. You're not into star restaurants. So you see the world. You understand everything. You understand every religion, every country is different. All mindsets are different. They look at the life in a different way. Every person looks into life in a different way. So if you want to see the world, you have to see people. You don't have to see shrines and monuments. You will not understand anything about it. No. This is only tick marks, I would say. This is only the tick mark boxes. Like I went, you know, a lot of people travel. Well, I went to London, I saw this. I went here and I saw this. They're just tick marking it. It's like a bucket list. I would say you should understand people of that particular area, the culture. Understanding people is what they eat, what they think, what is their normal life, how they look at life. Once you understand the people, you'll understand history, you'll understand geography. But if you don't understand people and their thought process, you're not going to understand those monuments and those shrines which are around there. So you have to understand people, I believe.
And the amount you travel and the different countries that you race in, the terrain would be very different everywhere. It must be desert and must be snow. So how do you tackle that and what are the difficulties that you face during this entire process?
See, actually, about the best thing about the rally driver, he should have good adaptability.
Yes.
Is the key. You drive in Himalayas, above 15,000, 18,000 feet, you should be able to drive there. You should not be scared of heights and driving to guards. You drive in deserts, it's going to be flat terrain, all loose soil, you might get stuck. The big dunes, you are going up and down. So you should be able to drive in deserts. You go to snow, ice rallies we have, temperature is minus 30. So you should be able to survive in that self. You should be able to eat, sleep, walk and drive car in minus 30 also. So there are all sorts of different terrains. Where you have to drive, you have to perform. So the most important thing is you have to adapt to the natures and the conditions there. So you have to get very fast tuned in. You have to be ahead of the game. You can't be behind. You have to be ahead of the game. So you try to go 1 week before or 10 days or 8 days, get used to it. And in rally schools also, we learn the terrains, what we are going to drive. So it's a combination of everything. And it's more, I would say, it's adaptability to drive in different conditions and understand all different conditions. And how could I drive my cars in snow, how could I drive in deserts and how could I drive in gravel roads or tarmac roads or so on.
And I was fortunate enough to see one of the videos of you driving, and it really was something new to me that I did not know that you could actually even drive blindfolded, because it's all about the hearing. You're not seeing and driving. I'd just like to give our audiences a little bit of insight on that.
Yes, suppose you're driving at a high speed in a ghat section, there's a lot of fog.
Yes.
You can't see anything.
True.
But these people, all these WRC drivers, they drive flat out in fog and they listen and drive. They exactly know what's coming, what to turn, when to turn, how much distance to drive. So normally it's like listening and driving. Even in forest stages, as you have seen in the video, there are trees coming at you so fast and the road goes between the trees. So there's no chance you can see, or you can't see the other side of the crest, what's coming and how it's going to turn. So we have to listen to the pace notes. We have our own language called pace notes. So that notes are to decide pace and where to keep the car.
Okay.
So we drive as per the navigator's call. And we have to rely on it 110%. 100% is not enough.
Yeah.
And we have to have a photogenic memory also.
Yeah.
Once the call comes into your ear, you should be able to visualize. If you visualize what's coming, then it becomes very easy. So it has to be a habit. And you have to develop this habit to drive, listen and drive. Because after a certain point, there's no way you can look and drive. You're going to lose a lot of time.
I'm sure you have become such an inspiration for all the youth in our country. So, if somebody did want to take up racing and rallying, how would they get into it, and what would your advice be to them on how to, you know, take the correct path towards it?
Well, now with this, now they got a Polo Cup for the junior championship. So, now with a lot of the companies, a lot of things have come up now, last 5 years and all. Go-karting, karting championship, all the rookies are coming in, there are tests for a lot of people to come. They go all over the cities to scout for new talent. So now last 5 years, this sport is picking up in India. Of course, Europe is ahead of us, but India is now picking up and all. And I think there's a lot of work for the people. There's a lot of careers to be done. You can be a racer, you can be a co-driver, you can be an engineer, you can be a manager, you can be a logistic consultant. A lot of things can be done into motorsports, because it's one of the biggest industry in the world, the motor industry. So you can do a lot of things here. So I would say to youngsters, please come. There's a lot of opportunities, I would say, in motorsports, in different sections also.
Okay.
You can be a tire engineer, you can be a race engineer, you can be an engine engineer. So many things can be done. So you can look at it as a career, I'm sure. And as far as the question is consider driving, yes.
Yes.
If you become a professional driver, you get sponsorships now.
Yes.
So you get paid for it now. So now things have changed a lot, and I think the next generation will have a better salary than what we used to get.
But I'm sure it requires a skill set as well, and the amount of time and dedication that goes into it must be a lot. So could you just let us know that how much time you need to set aside for it, or how dedicated you need to be for it? Because I think once you're in, you need to go the entire way.
Yes, you see, without sacrifice, nothing will come. So all the goodies has to go.
Yes.
But then this is the goodie you have to look after. Time, yes, you have to give time, but at the same time, I did business. I did whatever I have to do, survive, and most of the time I spend on motorsports.
Yeah.
Like, you don't have to go for races, but you can do a lot of studies, back work, homework, and a lot of other things you can do. You can train yourself, go to the gym, get fit, read more. Now with the internet, you can have more knowledge. You can go to watch some races, you can go to training school.
Yeah.
It's up to you how you plan yourself. So now with modern technology and modern things, you can do a lot of things, I believe.
And I would just like you to give a little message to everybody who wants to, you know, follow your footsteps and be inspired by you. Just say a few words to them.
Well, my message is very simple. Live your passion. It's important you live what you want to live for. Never leave your passion at any point of time. Otherwise, you are just like a robot. Like you do like robotic things. You go to office, come back, and there's no feeling about it. So I would say, apart from motorsports also, whatever you want to do in life, you should do. That's very important. That will keep you going. You will not get tired. You are doing what you want to do. That's very important. So don't leave your passion at any point of time. Age is only a number. If you leave your passion, you are living. Otherwise, you are just a robot, I would say.
True. So this is the end of our interview, and we would really like to thank you for being there with us and hearing us. And I'm so excited that I got to speak with such an inspiring man, and it's so admirable with all the achievements that you've made. Hats off to you, sir, and it was absolutely a pleasure.
Thank you very much. It was an honor speaking to you, and I hope the motorsports goes forward and India goes forward from here.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.